of cleft construction and linkage is what is known as pseudo-cleft, which starts with what followed by other construction. So the pseudo-cleft of A is what disgusted me was his behavior with snakes. So sentences A and B, that is the cleft and the pseudo-cleft, produce something disgusted me. Furthermore, still on this syntactic triggers or how sentence structures can trigger or produce presupposition. Certain types of subordinate clauses may trigger presupposition. For example, let's take two, time adverbial clauses and comparative clauses. In the following sentences, the A sentence has a presupposition in B. Example sentence A, I was riding motorcycles before you learned to walk. And let me pose the question, what kind of sentence is this? What kind of sentence is this? I was riding motorcycles before you learned to walk. Of course, this is a complex sentence, but functionally, one can say that this has to do with what is called time adverbial, as signaled by the conjunction before. I was riding motorcycles, that is the main clause, followed by the subordinate clause, before you learn to walk. The presupposition is embedded in the complement or subordinate clause before you learn to walk. In fact, this is very easy to decipher. So I was learning motorcycles before you learn to walk. Presupposes you learn to walk. As I said, the presupposition is embedded in the complement clause. That is the clause that follows the main clause. Let's take another example. Is even more gullible than you are. Is even more gullible than you are. This is known in English as a comparative clause because here we are trying to compare two things. Okay? Again, here we are dealing with a complex construction. Okay, a sentence that has two clauses. So, what is the main clause here? The main clause here is he is even more gullible, and then the subordinate clause is than you are. So, the question is, what is presupposed here? What is presupposed here is embedded in the complement or subordinate clause. So, sentence A, of course, presupposes sentence B. And this, and that brings us to our final example of semantic relations at the sentence level. And this has to do with thematic roles. Thematic roles. And the precursor of thematic roles is what is known as case graph, first proposed by Professor Charles Fillmore in 1968. And according to Fillmore, the case notions are a set of universal concepts and he defines them purely in semantic terms. In case grammar, the sentence in its basic structure consists of a verb and one or more noun phrases or nominals is associated with the verb in a particular case relationship. Fillmore originally proposes six cases as follows: agentive, instrumental, dative, factitive, locative, and objective. However, one of his students, that is Professor David Doughty, especially in the 1980s, refined and developed case grammar, and that is the work of his master, by proposing thematic roles. In Doughty's account, each nominal, that is each noun or a noun phrase in a sentence, fills one of a limited number of thematic roles with respect to the verb. And of course, Doughty gave us nine major thematic roles as follows. The first one he calls the agent. And what does he mean by the agent? The agent is the initiator of some action, capable of acting with volition, that is self-will, willingly. For example, in the sentence, David cooked the rice. Of course, who cooked the rice? David. So here, David is the agent. Or the fox jumped over the fence. What jumped over the fence is the fox. So the fox here is the agent or the doer or performer of the action. The second role is called the patient. The second thematic role is known as the patient. And as defined, the cake, where I am the beneficiary because I have benefited from the cake being baked. The sixth thematic role is called the instrument. Again, quite straightforward. And what is the instrument? This is the means by which an action is performed or something comes about. For example, she cleaned the wound with an antiseptic. She cleaned the wound with an antiseptic wipe. Where, of course, an antiseptic wipe is what is used, that is the instrument used to clean the wound. Sentence B, they signed the treaty with the same pen. They signed the treaty with the same pen. Where the nominal, the same pen, refers to the instrument used to sign the treaty. The seventh thematic role relates to what is called the location. The location, of course, is the place in which something is situated or takes place. For example, the cat was hiding under the bed, which triggers the question, where is the cat hiding under the bed? Of course, that is the location. And take the second example, the band played in the mall. Again, this is quite straightforward. Where did the band play? In the mall. Of course, that describes the location of the band. And then eighth, the eighth thematic role is called the goal. The goal is the entity towards which something moves, either literally, that is physically, as in sentence A, she handed a license to the police officer. She handed a license to the police officer. Of course, the police, the police officer is the goal of the action to the police officer. That is the goal. And of course, physically, she handed, in physical terms, she handed a license to the police officer. The converse of that is that the goal might be the entity towards which something moves, metaphorically or figuratively, as in sentence B, Pat told the joke to his friends. To his friends, in this example, is the metaphoric goal. Okay, because here, nothing physical is involved. What is involved is a kind of mental process. That is the, telling jokes has nothing to do with physicality. Okay? And finally, we have the source functioning as thematic role in sentences. And in contrast to the goal, the source is the entity from which something moves, either literally, as in sentence A, the plane came back from Lagos. Where from Lagos, of course, is the source of the plane, from Lagos. Conversely, the source might be the entity from which something moves, metaphorically or figuratively, as in sentence B, we got the idea from a French magazine. We got the idea from a French magazine. Where from a French magazine is the figurative or the metaphoric source, you know? Because of course, when you get an idea from somebody, there's no physicality involved. There's nothing physical involved, you know? The transaction, of course, took place in the brain or in the reader's mind. Okay. The major problem with thematic roads, as pointed out for example, Professor Saeed, you know, is that certain authors disagree about what, if any, distinctions are to be made between patient and frame, for example, or between agent and related roles, like actor, beneficiary, experiencer, and so on. For example, writing in 1988, Professor Andrew Radford treats patient and theme as different names for the same role. However, Professor Doughty, in various publications, adopts the distinction that patient is reserved for entities acted upon and changed by the verb's action, while theme describes an entity moved in literal or figurative space by the action of the verb, but constitutionally unchanged. Thus, according to Doughty, the noun phrase "the rock" would be a patient in A, but a theme in B, and the following examples. Sentence A, Fred shattered the rock. What we should focus on here, is the rock, which is the nominal here. So, for Professor Doughty, the rock, when used in association with shattered, okay, means that the rock in this context is the patient, because by shattering the rock, you have changed its state. Compared to Fred threw the rock, when you associate the verb threw with the rock, for Professor Doughty, the rock here is the theme, because by throwing the rock, you have not changed the state of the rock. But of course, Professor Radford would disagree by saying that in sentences A and B, the rock, you know, is semantically the thing. In other words, there's no difference between the two uses of the rock. In conclusion, in this chapter, we have examined semantic relations in English, paying close attention to the lexical and sentence levels. We have pointed out that semantics and pragmatics are distinct, though complementary and interrelated fields of study. However, I need to point out that Kant's constraint of space have precluded the discussion of certain key concepts in relation to semantic relations in English. For example, in relation to linguistic approaches to reference, we could not treat in detail the distinctions between referring and non-referring expressions, constant and variable reference, neither could we give exhaustive definitions and conceptualizations of referential concepts such as reference, extensions, prototype, stereotype, names, and nominals. If you want to know more about all these concepts, I will advise you to read the book by Professor Saeed, titled Semantics. Furthermore, the view of semantic relations espoused in this chapter has been largely Eurocentric, and that means the views have been largely borrowed from the Western world, that is, from European and North American scholars. However, as we try to point out in this chapter, given the fact that English is used or learned as a second or foreign language in most non-native contexts For example, African users of English are continually bending the language to reflect their African sociocultural experience. And in adapting and adopting the language to various cultural exigencies, African users of English are continually expanding the lexicosemantic resources of the language. In other words, consciously or subconsciously, African users of English are creating new lexical items in English and meanings to suit their own cultural and social imperatives. For example, what is commonly known in the Western world as traffic jam is known in Nigeria as go slow or hold up. For example, I have in various publications, particularly in 1991 and 1994, identified the various meanings being conveyed by African speakers and users of English. Once again, my name is Professor Edmond Bamilo, and that has been the contribution to the book on GST. Thanks for listening, my dear students, and God bless you all.